Hello everyone, I am Gargi Chatterjee and welcome back to my channel called Happiness Potli of Gargi. In my previous video, I talked about prehistory, how this word came in front of us and how this word has established as an individual subject. Today, by stepping forward to it, I am going to talk about the basic concept of human evolution. So, be ready to know about how we become what we are today. Today, I am going to discuss the basic concept of human evolution, and I have named the theme Hominini to Human, a journey towards humanity. In my previous video, I have already discussed this five important phenomenon which prepared a firm foundation on which prehistory as a word and a separate discipline had been established. And we already know that among those five important events, one was Darwin's revolutionary theory of evolution, in which he claimed that the forefather of ape and human was same, and human has got his or her present shape through a long and gradual process of evolution. And by the influence of Darwin's theory, many scientists had started searching for early human or hominin remains from all over the world, resulting discoveries of hominin remains from different parts of Asia, Africa, and Europe. However, before discussing those early human remains and their journey through the lane of evolution, one needs to know the position of human in animal kingdom for better understanding. After Darwin's theory and subsequent researches, human's position could have been established in the animal kingdom, and I am giving the very basic information of it. The animal kingdom has been divided broadly into two categories on the basis of the presence of notochord on the back, and they are chordata and non-chordata. In the category chordata, there is a subcategory called vertebrate, which means those who have proper backbone or spinal cord. And vertebrates include mammals, birds, reptiles, amphibians, and fish. Mammals is having several groups in it, including primate or primate. Primate or primate has two main categories, hominidae and pongidae. Pongidae further evolved to apes and hominidae to human. Therefore, both human and ape had same ancestor called primate or primate. Now, why human had experienced such elaborate evolution process? Firstly, because human has an unique physical feature or structure that they can control to their entire body. And that is why they were able to perform several technological trial and errors to adapt to their environments, which leads to a slow and gradual process of evolution from hominini to human. However, among these two, only the first point I will discuss through this video. The second one will be dealt with in future videos. So, what are those physical features that make human unique in entire animal kingdom? First is the spinal cord. It is so flexible that can be bent in different directions according to the need. The second is constantly developing an ultimate developed cranium. The third is its flexible fingers and especially the thumb, which makes human hold something in appropriate way. Next is the developed pelvis for making better posture. And the fifth one is the feature of human eyes to concentrate on something and identify the colors. The next one is humans developed U-shaped dentition, which makes them chew and eat properly. And the limb joints, which once again helps making different postures. These are the things make human unique in entire animal kingdom. As I have told earlier, that after establishment of Darwin's theory, people searched and found hominin remains from different parts of the world. And among them, the identified and major species are these, which are arranged roughly in this order. However, keep one thing in mind,
that this species never appeared one after another all the time. Sometimes some of them lived parallelly with each other, like Australopithecus and Homo habilis, Neanderthal and Homo sapiens. Therefore, the lane of evolution was more like this, irregular kind. The first is Dryopithecus. This species unable to balance their body on feet. Their dentition was little different than apes. This species dated between 15 to 14 million years ago. This one is the very first species with whom a different family of primate introduced called Hominidae, as I have already mentioned earlier. Initially, its remains found from Shivalik range, named as Hanuman or Sugriv-Pithecus and Rama or Shiva-Pithecus. Afterwards, it's also found from Africa called Kenya-Pithecus. The next is Australopithecus. Australopithecus means African ape. First found from South Africa by Raymond Dart. The existence of this species continued from 3.2 to 1.4 million years ago. However, Australopithecus was the species which first walked upright, or you may say tried to walk upright. This species has ape-like facial feature, but dentition and some other features are little different than ape. However, Homo genus didn't appear yet. Its cranial capacity was also better or developed than ape. It is considered that Australopithecus was both tree and ground dweller, which means they started to come down from tree and explored the world. However, Australopithecus had several categories. Among them, the most important findings were the South African findings and the East African findings. The South African findings were named as Australopithecus africanus, which were considered to be evolved to Australopithecus robustus further. And the East African findings are named as Australopithecus afarensis. The famous Lucy was an afarensis. The other type of East African Australopithecus was Australopithecus boisei. The Australopithecus boisei considered as super robust. Because it's larger in size, its features were more like human. They were capable of balancing their body weight on feet. And these species were considered as completely ground dweller and stayed in group. They were dated between 2.4 to 1.4 million years ago. Zinzanthropus boisei is associated with the pebble tools at Olduvai Gorge, East Africa. Therefore, are they the first tool makers? Let's see later. The next species is Homo habilis. Its remains were discovered by LSB Leakey for the first time from Olduvai Gorge. The Homo genus introduced for the first time. Their brain size were larger than Australopithecus and they were heavier than Australopithecus and had longer lower portion. Dentition were more like human and better ability to stand. Their thumb formation were also better than Australopithecus. This species, Homo habilis, were dated between 2.4 to 1.5 million years ago. Homo habilis were also associated with pebble tools of Olduvai Gorge, just like Zinzanthropus boisei, which I have talked earlier. Then, who was the first toolmaker and a true Homo? Either Zinzanthropus boisei or Homo habilis, because these two species are contemporary to each other. And both of these were associated with the pebble tools of Bedouin Olduvai Gorge. However, the life scientist and anthropologist consider Homo habilis as a true Homo on the basis of the presence of Homo genus in it. But archaeologists believed Zinzanthropus boisei as a true Homo, as it was the first species who was the author of a culture, you may say tool-making culture. However, later, by studying the marks on the skull cap of Zinzanthropus, it is said and considered that it used to be killed and eaten by Homo habilis. Means the Zinzanthropus were eaten and killed and eaten by Homo habilis. And it was accepted globally that Homo habilis were the first toolmaker and the true Homo. The next is Homo erectus. The remains of Homo erectus was discovered firstly by Eugene Dubois from Java, and he named the remains as Pithecanthropus erectus. The main feature of Homo erectus was its erect position, means completely proper erect position. It had longer leg and shorter arms and larger brain than the previous species. It was a skilled toolmaker associated with pebble tool cultures in Java and China, pebble tools and Abyssinian hand axes in Europe, Acheulean in Africa, and late Acheulean and Middle Paleolithic in South Asia, in India. Homo erectus was an ultimate hunter, led a communal life or a group life, and started using fire. Probably they also had started using language. Homo erectus was dated between 1.8 to 0.5 million year ago in general. As Homo erectus were found from different parts of the world, therefore they had some regional features also, and they were also named regionally, which we can see here. The next species was the early Homo sapiens. It has two broad categories, the pre-Neanderthal and pre-Sapiens. Both of them had much developed cranial capacities. It is considered that the pre-Neanderthal further evolved to Homo Neanderthalensis, and the pre-Sapiens were evolved to Homo sapiens. The next species was the famous one, the Homo Neanderthalensis. This species firstly discovered from the site Dusseldorf near Neanderthal Valley, Germany, and its remains were mostly found from different parts of Europe. The Neanderthal, the Homo Neanderthalensis, had a very developed cranial capacity. Even its cranial capacity was more than the modern human. Along with cranial capacity, its spinal cord were also developed, but its facial features were not that developed. Along with Mousterian tool-making culture of Europe, Homo Neanderthalensis were also associated with other cultural evidences such as making of hearts, burial practices, etc. This species was dated around 0.5 million years ago in general. And it is considered that this species lived for a shorter time and extinct. And the next is Homo sapiens. Once again, its remains were also found from Europe mostly, and it was associated with Upper Paleolithic culture onwards. It also had a developed cranial capacity. From the Homo sapiens species, we can see four distinct branches which were developed or evolved to the racial features, which we can see also in the present day situation. The Grimaldi man developed into Negroid, Cro-Magnon man developed into Caucasoid. The Pridmost man had mixed feature of Cro-Magnon and Neanderthal. The Chancellate man developed into Mongoloid. So this was the story of how hominini evolved to human. Hope you have enjoyed this video. And thank you so much for listening. And if my videos are helpful, then kindly like them, share them, and subscribe to my channel. Take very good care of yourself. Bye-bye.